Welcome back to Finishing Strong. And we are getting stronger every day, aren't we? Our faith is growing stronger, and we're learning more about God's creative power and His wonderful creation. We're diving into the three angels' messages, and we're growing closer to Jesus, and that's what it's all about. I'm Dr. Sandy from Three Angels for Kids, and today we'll have special greetings from the Director of Education for the Southern Union. Let's begin with prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for blessing us. Thank you for creating such a beautiful world for us to enjoy. I pray that you'll help us all to remember to honor you and give you praise and to worship you for being the creator of all things. We thank you, Jesus, in your name. Amen. And now, Mr. Murray Cooper.
Hello, my name is Murray Cooper, and I'm the Education Director for the Southern Union Conference. And it's my privilege to just spend a minute or two with you today as you continue on with your meeting to just reinvigorate and recharge everybody on a spiritual level as you finish up another very, very busy school year. When I hear the term finish strong, what comes to my mind is that of running races. When I was back in middle school at my church school way back in the day, we'd always have a spring track meet, and I always loved running in the races, and I always tried to think of I need to stay as close to the front of the pack as I can, but save enough energy so for that final 50 yards or 100 yards or whatever it would be, I have that extra burst of energy so I can finish the race as strong as possible and hopefully win the race. Paul, 1 Corinthians 9, verse 24, says, run the race to the best of your ability so that you run to win the prize. What's the prize Paul is talking about? Well, I suppose there's, you know, several different things that you could look at. But in context of the meetings that you have this week, that prize is getting to know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and accept Him into your life. There's nothing more important than that. Perhaps you've not yet made a decision to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. There's no time like the present to make that decision. Jesus longs to be with you, longs to be your best friend. There's no decision, no other choice that you can make that is more important to your life. Perhaps that, you know, you've kind of had that as part of your deal for a while, but it's kind of slipped to the background and it's not important to you now as it once was. And I want to encourage you to reopen that relationship with Jesus Christ, reconnect with Him, reconcentrate yourself to Him. He wants to be with you. He wants to guide you and direct you and lead you day by day, step by step, to help you be the best person you can be. But most importantly, that someday He can live with you. You can live with Him in heaven and spend eternity with Him, your best friend, Jesus Christ.
The verse for today is Genesis 1, 24 and 25. And God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping thing and beast of the earth after his kind, and it was so. And God made the beast of the earth after his kind, and cattle after their kind, and everything that creepeth upon the earth after his kind, and God saw that it was good.
Thank you. everyone. I was just thinking, there's somebody else you all need to meet. Did you know that Dr. Sandy is not the only one standing by to answer your questions, encourage you in your spiritual walk, and take your prayer requests? Well, Miss Yvette is a big part of the Three Angels for Kids and Three Angels for Today team. You can even email Dr. Sandy or Miss Yvette directly. They'll be super happy to hear from you. Let's bring in Miss Yvette now, and then we'll get right into our devotion with Dr. Sandy.
Hello, students, teachers, administrators, everyone watching. I am so excited to meet you. We've been working very hard on the week of prayer because we want it to be a blessing for you, your class, and the entire school. I want you to know I am praying for you, and I am here to help you in any way that I can. If you would like to contact us, please see the email addresses at the bottom of the screen. Okay, it's time for our devotional for today. Let's see what Dr. Sandy has to share with us.
Good morning, boys and girls. I'm so excited to be back with you today, and I have a question for you. Did anyone share something they learned in the last session with anybody at home? Great! Because Revelation 14 tells us that God made the earth, the sea, the springs of water, and everything in them, and for us to go and share His creative power. And that applies to everything we learned, from praying mantises to animals of all kinds, squirrels and bugs, right? So I'm so glad that we're able to talk about this and that we're able to worship God on His seventh day Sabbath and to tell everyone about how wonderful He is. So I'm going to share with you today about my very favorite animal. It's a very peaceful animal, very good natured. I wonder if it's anybody else's favorite animal. Does anyone have a guess? Okay, well, here we go. What do you think about this guy? There's a lot to love, isn't there? God made him to be the tallest animal. Did you know that a giraffe can look in on you if you're in a second story window? How would you like to be upstairs in your house and see this guy looking in on you? His neck is 6 feet long and weighs 600 pounds. And if you're wondering how 6 feet long, how tall that is, what that is about, think of an average to tall man. And that's about 6 feet tall. So do you know any average to tall men? Well, that's the length of a giraffe's neck. And how many bones do you think are in his neck? Let me give you a hint. We have 7 bones in our neck. So if there's 7 bones in our neck, how many bones do you think there might be in a giraffe's neck? The answer is 7. Did you think there would be a lot more? God used something we call economy of design when he makes his creatures. What he does is he comes up with this master plan. He's the master engineer. And then he's able to use this plan over and over again on different creatures. So the giraffe has the same number of bones in his neck as we do. His bones are just a lot bigger than ours are. His heart is a lot bigger too. It's 2 feet long and it weighs about 25 pounds. But that's not even that large when you compare it to his body size. Do you know that the giraffe's heart has a really big job to do? It has to pump the blood all the way up that long neck to his head. So how did God get that to work? Well, a giraffe has a very high blood pressure and his heart beats 170 times a minute. It's twice as fast as ours. The right side of his heart pumps the blood a short distance to the lungs, then the left side takes over. Now the left side of his heart has very thick muscles and it's able to shoot that blood from the lungs all the way up his neck to the brain. God knew what he was doing when he made the giraffe. His lungs can actually hold 12 gallons of air and are about 8 times larger than ours. Why do you think his lungs need to be so big? If they weren't that big, a giraffe would breathe the same air over and over again since his neck is so long. Now what about his legs? How long do you think his legs are? They're about the same size as his neck.
So they're also about 6 feet. So if you know a man who's average to tall, he's the same height as the giraffe's legs. If he was standing by the giraffe, he'd only come up to the top of the legs. So sometimes it looks like the back and the front legs are different sizes, but they're all the same size. They just look a little funny when he's trying to take a drink. And speaking of drinking, a giraffe gets most of his water from the leaves that he's chewing on. He can take in gallons and gallons, 16 gallons at a time, but he wouldn't feel that safe to stay down by the pond for that long. But guess how long he eats all day long? He eats for 20 hours a day because he's eating all 75 pounds of leaves. But how can he eat that long? Well, guess what? How much sleep do you think a giraffe needs? We need 8 hours. Sometimes kitties like to sleep for 16 hours. Cats sleep for 16 hours a day. The giraffe only needs 10 to 30 minutes of sleep a day. So that's why he has time to eat 75 pounds of leaves. He just takes his little nap while his friend looks out to make sure his predators aren't around, and the only predator he has is the lion. And then he's good to go for the rest of the day. But what about those leaves that he's eating? Well, he doesn't have any competitors there. Nobody else could reach that high, but not only that. He likes to eat the acacia leaves, and they have these sharp thorns, so nobody else wants to eat the acacia leaves. So how did God take care of that little problem? He coated his tongue with a thick saliva so he's able to eat those. And thinking about his tongue, how long do you think his tongue is? 18 inches, that's a foot and a half, like your little ruler plus half again. And why do you think a giraffe's tongue is black? Well, God made it that way because he knows he's going to have it sticking out eating all day, and he didn't want it to get sunburned. There are so many reasons for us to give God glory, aren't there? Have you ever noticed that there's all different kind of patterns on giraffes when you look at different pictures? God made at least 9 different kinds of giraffes so they can blend in with their background. And do you remember what that calls when you blend in with your background? Remember when we studied the praying mantises? That's right, it's called camouflage. So God made all these cool ideas, and then he put them on all different kinds of creatures, from the tiniest bug you hold in your hand all the way up to the largest and tallest giraffe. And you know, those spots can be black or white, light or dark. Each giraffe has its own unique markings, just like fingerprints. Have you ever wondered why a giraffe doesn't make a sound? Well, guess what? He does. We just can't hear it because it's below the level at which we can usually hear. But he actually can moo, sniff, roar, grunt, all of these. There's one noise we can hear, and that's the snort. And he'll do that if a lion is coming. So if you're out on the savannah and you hear a giraffe snorting, I think you better get moving. And speaking of moving, how fast do you think a giraffe can run? He can go up to 30 miles an hour. That's about as fast as a car on a side road. And if you see a giraffe running, you can't miss his tail swinging. That's because his tail is 8 feet long. Oh boy, but before we start to draw our very own giraffe, I have something else to tell you. Last year, my husband wanted to get me a special present for Christmas. So what do you think it was? It wasn't this special homemade giraffe. This was given to me by a very special teacher friend of mine down in Port Charlotte. And she knew I liked giraffes. It wasn't this giraffe mask. I got this at the San Diego Wild Animal Farm. Many years ago, I've had this mask for a long time. Nope, it wasn't a pet giraffe. Wasn't one of these toy giraffes. He arranged for me to take a trip to a giraffe ranch so I could spend an hour all by myself with a herd of giraffes and their babies. Would you like to see some of the pictures? Look at the little one. That was one of the babies. He was just so cute. I loved all of them. They were so sweet. A real treat for giraffes is cabbage. I was given a whole bucket of cabbage to feed them. At first I was a little scared, but then I found out they don't have top teeth. They just have the teeth on the bottom, so I didn't have to worry about getting my fingers chomped. But my heart was kind of pounding when they all wanted the cabbage at once, because they are very big animals. My goodness, what an amazing world we live in. God is just so good to give us all these wonderful and beautiful creatures, isn't he? Okay, are you ready to draw your giraffe? Now let's remember our promises. Repeat after me. I will not compare my work with others. I will not compare my work with others. I will have fun. I will have fun. I will not get frustrated or give up. I will not get frustrated or give up. I can always try again later. Okay? Have fun, and I'll see you back here in a little while. We're going to start with these fur-covered horns at the top of their head, and these are called ossicones. Okay, so just follow me. That wasn't hard, was it? Now we're going to make the eye sockets. Just come down and around. Same thing on the other side. You're going to pick up, down and around, back in. Just follow me. It doesn't look like it yet, but just trust me. We're making the ears now. It kind of looks like a leaf right there by the eye socket, and another line inside there for the edge of the ear. Now the ear on the other side kind of looks like another leaf down to the eye socket, and that little line inside to make the edge. Now we're going to make her beautiful eyes right there below where you left off. I made a few eyelashes here. Now you're just going to make your circle for the eye. Color that eye in, and remember to leave that little place where you see the glint of light. Just one tiny little place in there and fill that eye in. We can always fix it up a little bit later too. Then let's make the eye on the other side. We're just going to go down, make a few eyelashes, make the eye down and around, make that little glint somewhere in there for the eye and color it in. It's not going to come out perfect, but it's okay. You're going to be surprised. It's going to look good. All right, you ready to make the rest? Down and around, kind of in and out there. So there's that part. Now the nose is going to kind of look like a little frog, the nose and mouth, okay? Okay, we're going to put in his nostrils now. He looks like a little frog's head, but it's starting to work, doesn't it? That looks like his eyes and his mouth. Now let's finish out this part of the face here. Down and around. It's starting to shape up, isn't it? I wish I had more room on this whiteboard for the neck, but that's all the room I have, so that's all I can make. Now we're going to start coloring in the different colors. But I want to put a little fur on the top of my ossicones. Now some giraffes have fur, have this black part at the top of the ossicones, and some don't. So mine does, yours doesn't have to if you don't want it to, it's okay. And I want to use kind of a highlighter now to put in some color. You might use a light crayon, whatever you have, just shade it in. But you notice I'm not filling it all in because I want to put different colors. So I'm just putting kind of some spots around. That's the beautiful thing about nature. No two are the same, so yours won't look like mine or your friend's, but you want to save room for different colors to drop in. That's what's going to make it look special. So I'm putting a little gray here, a little gray there. Then I'm going to pick up a different color highlighter, and I'm going to put in a second color, so, and then a third, and then a fourth. So now I'm putting in like a light orange. Somebody might say, giraffes aren't orange. Giraffes have all different colors, and this is my giraffe. I can make her how I want to make her. Okay, so I'm putting some spots, and remember, you don't want the spots to be all the same size. You don't want it to look perfect, or it will look like you bought it in Walmart or Target. Nature is very different and varied. Every spot is not the same size. Every spot is not the same shape. So I put in some orange. Now I'm going to put in some light brown. So I'm just going to color in around her nose here. You see how she's starting to shape up? She's looking pretty good. Putting a little more brown here, kind of adding to those other orangey spots a little bit. Then I'm going to kind of do the inside of the ears, nice light brown, so it looks like the inside, so that it's a different color than the outside. Now I'm going to put in the yellow. I love the yellow too. That makes it look really nice. See that? Filling it right in a little bit. You can be shading with your crayon, and you can always watch this again, and you can stop at different parts. But I just want to give you the basic idea now, coloring in yellow. So now we have the yellow, the gray. Now I'm going to stand back and say, am I finished, or is there something I want to add? That's what you do at the end. You look at your drawing. Yes, I bet you guessed what I'm doing here, right? I needed to add in some more eyelashes. And I'm going to give her a little shading under the chin. Let's see. A little more shading on the side of the neck. Mouth gets colored in a little bit here, nostrils, and I think I'm about done. What do you think? Do you like it? I hope yours is coming along nicely too. Great job, boys and girls. Don't forget to look closely at God's nature every day and give Him the glory for all He's made. See you next time as we continue to give God our praise and talk about more of His amazing creatures.